Hi guys, welcome, welcome back. How's everybody doing today? Let me put that phone on mute because if not, it's just gonna go off. So we're gonna do a little bit of organizing. We're going to switch a few drawers around. Excuse me, sir.
Hey.
Why don't go under that couch? Like, that little bunny is troublesome. You guys really liked him in the last video of him just coming out and running around. He's really cute and he has his moments, but I tell you, there is a lot of moments where he's a little bugger face. So I got a couple packages in from Allie. I always slice and dice to see what it is because I really don't know what it is until I get it. That one. Okay, good. So I'll show you guys. I'm still going to show it in a haul because you guys like to see it in hauls. So I wanted to try the Puente peel-off base. I look so tired. Why do I always look tired? Probably because I went to bed at like 3 in the morning. God, I'm terrible. So I wanted to try the peel-off base. So I got that. I got another 4-in-1 top coat. This works amazing with the peel-off base from... What's your name? Sunny? IBD. That's what I was going to say. The IBD peel-off base, it works. It's actually a peel. Like, it peels off. I can pop my nails off within seconds. But they also last. Like, they will last you a good week without popping off as long as you put it on. Don't move it and don't break that seal. They will still last you, like, a week, but very easily pop off. No damage to your natural nail. Love this stuff. Like, but it's too pricey. Like, the price went up on it. It was about, the shipping alone is $9 for me for Canada. And I'm really trying to find it in a local store, or I think I did order a couple more. The shipping was, Blue, please. The shipping was still $9, but then they upped the price to this. I think he's eating my couch. Are you eating? I swear, if I go over there and there's any chew marks on that couch. Wait, I have real issues with that little bunny. Yeah, so I did get two more, but the price of it was the same price that I originally paid. Because I asked the seller, like, why did you guys go up? Because the price of this was going up to, like, almost $10 for a bottle. Which I was like, I'm not paying $20. No, ma'am. So I wanted to try the peel-off base of the Puente brand to see how that works, if I could just go them, too. And then professional gel polish. Oh, it's a blooming gel. I got the blooming gel in Puente. I was like, what am I going to polish? So I wanted to see that. I don't know. He was trying to get under the couch. He's not allowed under the couch because I did, like, rabbit-proof the wires of the go behind my couch. But I still don't want him to get used to going under there because he'll stay there and he won't come. Tray that I used to be on my ottoman that I had. I put it under my couch to block it so he won't go there. I feel like he's still trying to push it back. He is smart one. So I'm going to eat, like, breakfast, lunch, whatever you want to call it. I haven't eaten anything for the day. I slept in a little bit because I went to bed so late, honestly, like 3:30 probably in the morning. I was up editing and just not good because I'm supposed to be up at my allotted time to work out and do everything, and I still worked out. I'm 2 weeks in. So I've been doing good. I don't know, I hurt my toe. There's something, like, I stepped on something, but I don't remember stepping on it. I didn't feel it, but my toe is a little sore. So I'm kind of keeping an eye on that. But I still did my workout. So I did all that, everything. I haven't eaten yet, so I want to make sure I eat before I get in the studio because it's terrible for me because I just won't eat and then I'll get hangry, y'all. Like, I get real hangry. Okay, so this was in a good bag. I don't know what it is. Okay. Oh, cool. It comes with a color stand. I didn't realize that. So I got some gel polish from this. Oh, it does, and it has color cubes. Well, isn't that, like, so cool? I didn't even realize it came with that. So I got some polish. These are all, like, new colors. But it's called FN. Because I can't read it. I don't know. Anyways, the bottles were gorgeous and I love them, but they're going to be these awkward bottles. But I think up here where I have the Madame Glams, I have a row that I can put them on and I can move my pixies to the wall. I changed a few things. I feel like in my life, in my YouTube life, like, is it just lighting? Because do I look like that bad? I have no makeup on today, guys. That's probably why. So my eyes are puffy and, you know, we just natural. It's a rainy day. I have the house to myself and I just want to get some organizing done. And the last thing I needed to do is like jazz up and look cute. Like, I'm good. I'm still cute. Anyways, so I look natural, basic, and I'm okay with that. Like, that rabbit is gonna drive me crazy. So these are what they look like. I love the bottles. I think they're so cute, but they're like these tricky ones to store, but oh my god, that color looks gorgeous. Look at that color. It's like, ooh, it's like a nice creamy, like brownie, but a tint of purple. I feel it's a good color. I ordered a few. I wanted to see them first. They're not the cheapest. I think a set of four is like 18-20 bucks, so it's not bad either. They're like $5 each, so it's really not bad. But like, and they're 15 mil, so actually it's really reasonable. I knew he's gonna fall off that thing. So I'm not gonna open all of them because I'll open them in the haul. But look, it actually came with color little things and a color card, so I could put that up. I don't know if I will or not. I think I will because they're so cute. No clue where I would put them. I don't have room for the color cards like that. The color 1, 2, 3, 4. But I got a pack of them. And I did order a couple more, actually. So I didn't want to go too crazy because I wanted to see how they were, the color and all that. But I ordered all the nudes. So now I was really looking at, like, they have an autumn kind of collection that I was looking at, and I was like, oh, could I get that? If I'm gonna get it, now would be the time to get like those really nice like oranges. And I know I probably have them in some other brand or thing, but they all vary. They all are different. But yeah, they have those little color swatch cubes too. So that was actually, I didn't realize they came with that. They advertise like they look like they came with it, but in a lot of the reviews are really, really good. But in the reviews, a lot of them said, oh, I thought it would come with a color card or something like that. And maybe people thought they came with the one that it looks like. And it's exactly how it looks, but it's already on it. This, you have to swatch it yourself. So that's kind of cool. I'm excited for those ones. Now I think I want to go order the other ones now that I see the quality. And it came pretty decently packed. So that's good. We're going to put this stuff... I'm just kind of cutting off my address on this one because I just can't, people. Ow! I cut my finger. I literally cut my skin. Well, I didn't cut it. I pinched it. I don't even need the package. So we're going to put this in the new product drawer. We have a few things. I changed my new product drawer. It used to be in this stand over here. And it was one of the big... the bottom of the Alex store units, and I just found I would let it pile up and then I would get so much stuff, and then it's like almost have to do two hauls at a time, which isn't a bad thing, but I really would like to have it where it's one haul, get it done, filmed, and I can get it away, so I'm just not like stocking up. And I always plan before I buy stuff. I think in my brain, this is how my brain works, and I think this is why I stay as organized as I do. You guys know I have a small space, or I say I have a small space, but I've made my space really, really work. Do you know what I mean? So with that being said, I have to pre-plan where's things gonna live. Like, how would that work? How would this go? I can't venture anymore out. Like, this is all I have. By me moving this drawer now over on the side and getting a smaller one, it freed up a little bit of wall space. So I actually did put a rack on my wall and I put all my CJS on that. Now, in an ideal world, when I get a room, because if I don't say if, when, choose to like upgrade and get a bigger home, then I ideally would pre-plan and try to have my own room for my office. for my studio. So I would can do that a little bit different, but here I don't have the wall space. So I ideally would like to have two side by side so they all can just be lined out. But this one I had to double up in this one, and I'll show you guys that when I come back. Because I'm going to try to eat my breakfast or lunch, whatever. I'm just having boiled eggs with avocado toast because it's delicious, in all truth. I love it any time of the day. And it's healthy. So I found on CJS, and I don't know why nobody told me this. Shame on y'all. Actually, I don't know if it's just they did that recently or they have had it and I just never realized it. But they actually have all the names of their polish. They have a printable sheet that you can get. So this is for their specialty polishes, and then this is for their regular polish. So I printed that out. You guys know I used to just do this little numbers, which worked great. And I come to realize with that, I only have like 4 or 5 colors to get, and pretty much like 6 of the hollows. I only have 1 of the hollows, and then that's it. I have the whole collection, so I don't have far to go. And I'm just not really rushing that. They do have a crazy sale on right now, but unfortunately what I want, the hollows, are not included in that sale, so I don't know if I'm gonna rush to get it right now. Like, it's not like a need, because a few colors are like, I want them, I'll get them eventually, but they're not that crazy. Like, I think one is a sheer white, so you know what I'm just saying, like, kind of like that. So this, anyways, they have all the names of the polishes. So now it's great for me too, also when I'm doing videos and stuff, I can be like, okay, number 9 is ready for anything, because they have the names of it right here. So I love that they did that. And they have the free spaces, so hard to see, that also come in the back, where they do not have like some of the collection out yet, or like on that little thing, so you can write it in. So I want to ideally do that at some point today too. I printed that off last night. And then I got 2 of these things from my local dollar store, which they were like $4. Dollar store, my arse. The dollar stores are not dollar stores anymore. The only dollar store, and it's not even a dollar store anymore, is Dollar Tree. Because everything here went up to $1.50. But it's still cheaper than Dollarama, because nothing in Dollarama is a dollar. Like, nothing. Like, I don't care. Like, oh, maybe like a candy bar. But like, everything's like $1.50 and up. Anyways, so I grabbed a couple of these. I have one. I'll show you guys when I take you guys off a movie. I'm just going to keep you on this for now. I do have one down there where I have my polishes, because it gets a little dark. But now, I think if I have the room, I want to put 3. And that way, I can have them for when I'm in the drawers and I'm like just doing artwork. I can just like hit them. They have remotes too. And then I can kind of see it'll cascade down on my drawer. I thought that would just look nice. So I'm going to put them up too. Just want to get them ready, but I have to get to my breakfast because those eggs have been sitting there and they're done. But I have to peel them, so they can cool for a minute. I don't even know if I should put these batteries in it, to be honest. I said batteries proper. Wow. You always say batteries, so I don't know. Probably because on here I get corrected for my speaking quite a bit. Some people like to correct and be like, oh, it's not this, it's that. Honestly, guys, I speak the way I speak, I talk the way I talk, and hopefully you can understand it. It's not like I don't think I sound that crazy or that off. Some words I just can't say, like, and I'm not stressing my brain to when I do this, and I've always said that with like anything in life. I'm not gonna let that deter me from being me. So I'm not gonna, because it's too much stress to be like, oh my god, I have to watch how I say that. I have to, and then you're trying so hard and it's not gonna come out naturally. So I talk the way I talk, and it might sound, I don't know, uneducated. It might sound country at some times. It might sound ghetto at some times. I don't know. Call it whatever you want to call it. It's me. Hello, I'm Crystal. Nice to meet you. That's it, guys. That's it. I got it. I'm over it. So anyways, I have like good, well, not good, but yeah, I guess good. I don't know. Whatever. These batteries, last time I put them in the other one, they died like right away. So I'm not even going to bother. I'm just going to leave them in here. Maybe they'll work in something better. That's, these probably are just sucking too much of them out. So I have some, like, the ones I buy from Costco, like the Duracell, I think they are, or not even sure of the brand actually, but anyways, I have a big pack that I have from Costco because I have all these candles that have low, and I wanted them all to like be on. I never use them, so they're just sitting there probably killing those batteries as well. Okay, so I'm just going to put all this in the recycling, and then when we come back, let's get to organizing. I'll show you guys that. And I got a couple of these little things from Dollar Tree. I want to see if they fit in the drawer. That could work too. We're going to change some gels around. We're going to change a few drawers around and see if we can put them over here, because I know I don't really reach for them that often. It's going to be a hodgepodge of organizing and seeing what can work, how we can just make all these drawers function a little bit better. I feel like if it can be closer to me, it works better rather than it being in my Alex drawer. I'd rather this Alex drawer over here, if it could be for more storage, but stuff that like I need and I want, but it doesn't, maybe I don't reach for all the time. Like my gels, I don't reach for them all the time. I really just reach for the Benelisa gels, in all truth. So they have their own separate drawer. All my other gels, they're just sitting there. So maybe I can use that big drawer for something else and just use a couple of smaller drawers over here. Might work, might not work, might have to move it all back. We don't know yet, but that's how we organize. We move stuff around to see it. If it works, great. If not, we put it back. All right, 17 minutes of gabbing and I'm gonna eat, and you'll see me back in 2 seconds.
You guys always say you want to see more of Blue, but this is where he usually chills. He's usually over there, either in that bed or like he just lays over in that corner. Bunnies like to hide. That's like their jam, right? They're prey animals, so that's usually where he is. The day that he was running around, he was just being a silly little dude. See, he doesn't even want to come out now. He wants to climb my walls. Crazy little man. Look at him pop his ear out. Come here. Are you gonna come? Come say hi. This is what he does all the time. He's up there like he's eating grass. Blue, get down. Like he literally is eating my blanket. This is what I mean. He is a crazy little dude. Blue, okay, come on. Mommy's gonna get up. All right. Don't jump down that way. Come on.
Okay guys, so we're over by the drawers. So this here is what I want to move regardless. I want to move my stamping stuff up. I feel like I reach for that more often, and then it'll be stamping, and then my other stamping drawer is right here. So that's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna take it all out. I'm gonna see if I can put this in my other Alex drawer system. I think what I'm gonna do is, this, there's not a lot of stuff in it right now, so I'm just gonna take it out, and I'm gonna use this tray just to transport stuff over, because yeah, so exciting. These are some custom gels that I've done. They're colored gels. I haven't showed you guys. I don't even know what this color that is. Oh, this is like a neon highlighter. So that is a hard gel. I don't know. I was thinking of doing some. I haven't done much with them yet. I have a few. Oh, this is like a green. Like a forest green. They're all made with IBD hard gel. So they all have my sticker on them because I customized them with pigments and stuff, so. Haven't done anything with them yet because I needed to really test them out before I even bring them out to like the world.
actually fits pretty good. So I just did that. Sorry, my phone rang. Yeah, I think that's fine. This was a little confusing because I was like, oh, I'm missing some numbers. But I guess the way that that kit came, the Savvy Land, it comes like as your builder and stuff. So I'm just going to leave the couple Nail Queen Studios. I probably won't get much more of them. I don't know. I like them. They're really nice. Very tiny. But they're hard to get right now, so for now I'll just leave them there. Or probably, hold on, let me change that, I think. Actually, like that will probably look better. Because I think that will come exactly. Sometimes you just gotta move things. See, that looks better. And then a few Nail Queen Studio, and then I'm gonna bring over some of the other gels. Oh, I'm really trying not to go through drawers. I think I might though if I go this way. Is that wasting space? I feel like some of those gels are garbage though, in my opinion. Okay guys, so I brought these back out. Now, these are just paper trays that I got from the dollar store, and I put this little, it was just a glitter paper also from the dollar store, and I got one of those sealers, so it doesn't seal it that great, but it holds it from anything falling through. And then I put a slippy little matte thing, or whatever you call them, there. And I just tried that. That will fit in this drawer. So it'll give me at least one more layer, which I like for the bottom ones and that. So now I can put the other gels on top, hopefully, and have enough room for everything. And only take up two drawers, which ideally that would be spectacular. Okay, let's see what we can put on. You guys can see, but the white one I was just using does not work for those drawers. And I have gels back here. I've never used that gel. I was thinking it was just really, really stiff. I've never given it a go. I should bring it out and give it a go. But again, I have a no practice hand, so I think that'll help me too. Just try different stuff, because this is not on myself. These gels, they're just so small. But it's a clear, so this says it's pink. Those pinks are pretty nice. They're pretty like clear pinks. The brand, I haven't worked with that brand a lot, to be honest. Let me get my cloth. So that's all that's back there. These gels, oh my god, honestly guys, I don't even use them. I bought them, they were very, very affordable. That's brand new. What is this? This is pink. That's what I want to give away. Pink. Brand new. That can go in a giveaway. Oh, a milky white. I think I turned this too into a milky white. That's like almost done. I feel like that can go in the garbage. Clear. I don't know much about that brand. I haven't really used it a lot. It's a soak off builder.
from Amazon. But I feel like the brand new ones, it says pink. So that's that pink. This is white. Doesn't even like look white. Looks very clear. White. Okay, brand new. That Milky White's garbage. And this is Milky White again. So I must have made up some Milky White. Well, I feel like, okay, then there's a little bit in that. I guess if I made the two. It gives me four, and then we have four to go in a giveaway. They can go in a giveaway. They're closed, so. This is like a brown. I already know what it is. And I've mixed it. I was trying to get like a good teddy bear brown. A set I was doing. These are canis. Honestly, I'm not a fan of these. Like, I'm not a fan. I'm going to try to work with them a little bit more and give them a bit of a chance. They did have curing issues when I swatched them. And I haven't even touched them since then. Which is crazy because I love Benelisa. And Benelisa is like a sister cani brand. Okay, we have Savvyland. I like Savvyland. That's what I started with because I didn't really, there wasn't much gel. That and IBD. That's a pretty pink. So, this is a reddish pink. That's pretty too. I feel like these though, guys, they're so small. You get 0.5 ounces. You're lucky if you do a long set, you're lucky if you get a full set out of that whole gel. At least me when I first started. Ugh. Is clear. Okay, that's a brand new clear. Pearl white. That is open. So I'm just gonna go in here. And this is scarlet. And that's another nice like pink. And here we go. This is a nude pink. This is what I was using which I really like that color. When I was doing my models, that's what I was using, Savvyland, that nude pink. This, I haven't really used this. I haven't even tried this one, this brand. I bought it, but it looks yellow and it's a clear. Like it automatically gives me a yellow hue. So I'm just like, that makes me iffy. Vendini. It's a pretty expensive brand. It's not like the cheapest brand out there. But I don't like how that yellow, or that white, or the clear, sorry, looks yellow. So that kind of freaked me out. These are, oh, I love these. These are the solid IBDs. These are brand new. These can go in my tips. I can't even go in there. Could I fit the gel in here? This one, they have a really high heat spike, I found this one did. They were good though, they worked good. It says it's a soak off. So it's always good to have some soak off. Let's see if I could just like snug them in there because there's four. And these are all open, I remember. I bought them off Amazon. Just fit back here. And I should have enough room. I will not be able to put that shelf in with these, so. These are all colored custom gels in 30 grams. Okay, I like it, I like it. So, M-Share is there a little thinner? M-Share Clear is super thin. It's honestly, it's more like a top coat, I feel. This is Benelisa. I love that color. Now, these will not fit in my other drawer, so I'm fine with leaving it over here. Like I said, it's not that crazy. I literally can wheel my desk over, or my chair over. But this is for when I'm encapsulating glitters. So it's just clear. It's always good to have a clear that you use for glitters, and then your clear that's just used for everything else, which is this one. That's a gorgeous color too. I love that color. Probably at the top. Oh, look at that. They're so full. I haven't used these in a minute. And I just bought the big ones and I filled these up. Because these is what I wanted to use for my models when I was doing that little program. But, you know, COVID, things went back into, like, kind of shutdown system. So, didn't overly do it. Okay, so clears should go up front. Clear and glitter. Actually, I think what I'm going to do, because that's still... Let's put the custom in the back. I'm going to put all my customs a little bit farther back because I'm not ready for them to see the world. Well, I guess I just showed you guys, but you know what I mean. I think just... Not yet. This is a good go-to. Like, this is a beautiful, beautiful nude color. I love that color. I'm gonna put that on my nails next. But these are a little thinner than the Jelly Joes. So you have to work with it. Not as big a bead, I find. Oh my god, that's actually gonna fit so beautiful. I love that. I think I'm just going to turn these colors just upside down so I can see the color tabs a little bit better. Because they're right there. That's perfect. Now we do have my Young Nails system, which... Yeah, I know I'm not gonna like that, but let me see something. If I can just do a small, because this won't fit there now, I don't think. See how that won't fit because these are taller, so I knew I wasn't gonna get that, and no, it won't fit that way either. Please believe. I don't think it will. It's too wide, right? Let me check. Yeah, this is too wide. So that's not going to fit in that one. I really don't want to go one more up because these kind of fit up here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to see if I have something smaller before I even go to cut that. And then I can put a little mat on these and then they won't slip. So let me go check my storage area. I usually do. I always keep the leftovers of them. Okay, so I'm just going to move you guys a smidge. So I'm back. One of these will fit in there nicely. And I think that will fit those gels perfect, or be perfect for it. So, too small. I always keep these like extras, and for a reason, I tell you. Sometimes you don't know when you just want a small piece of it. And they really do work, I tell you. They really, really do. Okay, so, and I'm gonna put this on the bottom of this. And the reason I'm going to do that is so it doesn't slide. It still will prevent it from sliding. Now we can put, what do we have? We have our concealer pink. Kind of a thicker one. We have our sculpting white. We have our clear sculpt, brand new, not open. And then we have our... Builder Joe. That one's almost empty. That one's low. And then we have a flex gel. Periscope flex gel. And then we have some of these little guys, which are like testers. Not testers, but they come in like a small kit. When I first started, I got this to see how I like young nails. Loved it. Got the whole gel kit, actually, which came with the bigger one. So there. And then that will live like this. Maybe like that, though. Yeah. I like it. Perfect. And then this, again, we have for all these ones. We still could do the same thing. We could have a little bit of room there if we needed. We'll do the same thing for now, and I'll just know that these are a giveaway. I need to find somebody like local that's into nails, because I feel like there's a lot of stuff that I've tried that it just doesn't work for me. But I would give even used if they were open to it. But you'd have to come like meet me and pick it up or something. Okay, so now that that's fine, I think because two will automatically always fit in here, I think why not prep for two, and then I'll just do the bottom of that as well. This will be fine.
Okay, so a small recap. That is how this one looks now. And that is perfectly fine. Like, that's going to stay. That won't slide around. And then this one, we have the taller ones in the back. We have our more colored. And then these two little containers fit perfectly, so that allows us to get above storage. So now we're getting double the storage in both of these. I think I like that a lot better. I still have this top one where I used to have stuff where I would either... Well, this I think I'm doing, putting gonna put that in a giveaway. So maybe I should put those dolls there, actually. So... Sorry, guys. We're gonna put these in here because I'm gonna put them in a giveaway. Or, like I said, I wish I knew people that live closer to me. Okay. There we go. So that's how that's gonna look. I know I have a couple other M-Share gels that I purchased that I wanna test out. I'm hoping they're jelly, I think, so I'm hoping they're thicker than this one. But, so, I have room to grow, and I always like to plan like that. I like to plan to grow in my spaces, because, let's be real, I like to buy stuff. So, and then this is poly gel. I think this is gonna stay. OMG, like, did my phone just go off? Right in the middle. Like, how am I gonna edit that bad boy out? Okay, my bad. The poly gel, I think this is gonna stay. But I just don't, like, I didn't even take these out because I don't, like, I just don't really use them. And I'm not overly a fan. It's a little thinner than I'm used to for poly gel, I find, the Benelisa's. What I've tried so far. I just don't really use poly gel, guys. I don't know, I have some Roslyn, though. Some mixed brands. I would say my favorite, though, was Tomica. I really love their clear. I used it all the time for a big blink. Worked great. I have a whole whack of Benelisa. You guys know me. I'm a little bit of a Benelisa whore. And then we have rhinestones down here. I think I might try to change my rhinestone area. We're going to see. We have a lot of organizing today to do. And then charms, 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 miscellaneous. I love that miscellaneous drawer. I think I'm going to try to recreate a little bit more like that of one. I have to get more, if I could find more of those containers, they're kind of sold out everywhere right now in the Dollar Tree. Okay, let's get back over here. And okay, so let's put this stuff back. I like to keep my berry berries. These are all of their cream gels. I like to keep them in the boxes for now. I have the room to do it, so for now I'm going to. I think they're cute and they just kind of sit there nicely. A couple of the candy cream gels, I love those colors. Some Born Pretty Solid gels. Maybe I'll do it this way, though. Kind of keep them a little separated in their own spaces. So I'm going to put this back in this drawer because that's where they live. All those drawers are doubled up. They all fit beautifully. So we have an empty drawer. A piece of glitter, of course. Okay, so let me see if I want to bring you guys a little closer. All right, let's get up here. Look at my little knobby knees. Get them from my mama. Okay. All joking aside, I really want to definitely put my stamping stuff up here because it's just going to be a little higher for me to grab.
One day we'll go through, guys, once, I don't know. Is there a point in me actually even labeling these? Because I change my stuff so much. But I like to have them labeled, because sometimes when you're just like, your brain's not working, it's so much easier and just be like, oh yeah, it's right here, here, here. You know what I mean? But we have to put a glitter there. You know that's good. That's glitter. I almost wish these drawers had the smaller ones at the bottom, because I would still have my glitter at the bottom because I don't reach for it all the time. But because these are thicker, it doesn't make sense to put glitter. It's a waste. But do you know what I mean though? Like, eh. And I wonder. Thoughts are things. I always say it. Just for future. Nope. See? Wouldn't fit. So I couldn't double that up. That's all I was curious to see. Could it be doubled up on its own without a tray? Probably not. Nope. So I guess if I had it in the bottom that were thicker, you could double them, but it wouldn't look as pretty. I keep that for, I don't know what reason. All these are just blank papers, but they have like that silk on them, so you can use it when you want to put like gels and stuff. I have a pad that does the same thing, like this. You want to mix up colors, but keep these. They trust me, they can come in handy, so I do keep them. Okay. Let's move up. I know, you're kind of gross, but... should probably keep. Keep one there. I like to keep like this, and you can keep reusing it to wipe off your scraper. They work good, and then you throw them out after when they get really gunky. So I do like to keep it there, because now I can use that side. Extra beads. These are stamping polishes, watercolors, and inks. I think I'm gonna put my chromes up here instead, because I really want to try to get into like chrome stamping. So chrome stamping, I think I'll put chromes with that instead of going that way. But I had it. Stamping. Again, I wish I had somebody that was like closer to me in Toronto. I'm in Toronto, Ontario. I kind of wish, because a lot of these, like, I would just, and I don't know if I really can put open stuff in giveaways. Like, I've tried it. Do you know what I mean? I want to keep my CADs. I like the way CADs works, but gels and stuff, I'm just not into them. And I have no issue giving them away. Like, I don't feel... people say keep them, but also, I don't know. I'm just a giving person, and I think that's my nature. So I say that, and it's, I don't know. It's just me. It's just how I am. I can't change that. Okay, stamper, clear pad, sticky pad. Company did that. I didn't like the way it came out. And these guys, I don't know. Just in case anybody didn't know. All these are is like lint rollers for your clothes. Just get a new lint roller and the head will go in there. I'm not quite sure how I take that out yet. I haven't tried it. I haven't had to. Oh, you just pull. And then probably pull again. So there's a way. But that's all they are. Just in case nobody knew, or sometimes we just don't think of things. Like, in all truth, guys. A little beverage. Oh, we have 4 chrome. Will that fit? I think that might fit though. I don't know if this is working any. I like the system. It keeps them organized. Actually, yeah. It does keep them organized. If I keep them in place, but it does take up a bit of room. Get 2 more in there. Organize if I put them back. I might have some mixed ones. And these are just, honestly guys, I haven't numbered them. I should. And put them in there, the systems. Oh, why do I keep opening that drawer? I don't want you, drawer. So technically, this is going to be a continuation. And then this is all of each one. If you guys don't know, each one of my things are numbered. So these are their little... applicators are numbered 2, and I use them until they're gunky, and I throw them out and I replace them. But I like that because you get way more use out of it, because you're not mixing the colors, and you don't have to worry about other colors going on other colors. That's how I do that chrome system. I haven't done anything with these because I haven't even opened them. I feel like it's going to be messy AF. I'm not a fan of how they came, but the day that I want to use them or choose to, I guess I'll see. But that's a really nice one though. But yeah, it's gonna be, she's gonna be messy. Even these ones, I have a lot of those colors though, so I feel like that could have went to giveaway, but I just feel so messy. I don't know if anybody would really even want to get that. Right? It's cool though. But for now, back there. Now, I want to see something. It's been in my brain to see, and so I'm going to see how many I can fit, and I want to see if I would consider moving my bling over to these 2 drawers and move all these over to that Alex drawer, or the drawer here. But I want to see how many would fit, if it makes sense. If not, I'm going to keep them in the tall ones because you get quite a bit of room in there. But the way my brain works, I got to see it. This is where... Okay. So, you'd only get 2. That doesn't make sense for me. I can get 10 in one of those drawers. So how many could I have? 2, 4, 6. I would get just about 10 in one of these drawers, and I feel like that's a lot more surface space to give up. So they work perfect where they are. Not doing that. But I'm glad I got that idea out of my brain. They're all down here. My inks and stuff can stay down here.
look and see if I have any more long ones. Ideally, two more long ones there would be more ideal, I think. Okay, guys, so I found one more, and I think that will work, and I think I'm going to clear up one of these ones for now. I can always get another one of these from Dollarama. They're pretty, like, standard where I live. I don't know, it's something. So that idea is not going to work. I ran out of room. These are all glass gels. Chun Chun. I think they're called Chun Chun. I don't know what they're called. But they're really nice. I like them. So I want to put something. I'm going to take this one because these are all in boxes. These are all just watercolors. Well, I can probably stay there, I guess. The boxes here. And then these couple can go like here. And then now I can have a smaller jar. Perfect. And now that one has two, and I'm going to move these over into one of these. Do I even have. See if I can get enough of one of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually move that little piece of foam back a smidge, or whatever you call it, the non-slip, and that'll actually help them stay up if you just move that back. So that is them, and I feel like that works a bit better, and again, I can just grab the whole thing and pull it out. Well, don't tilt it. Or you can just push them all the way back and then have the front, either or. I just think it looks more pleasing to go like that. Okay, another clear box. And then that we have for future. All inks, but I like that. I like the way that turned out. Oh, I'm hot. Oh yeah, okay, so this drawer here also. These work amazing. I use them to put my CJS polish in, so I could have a couple polishes out, and I put my cotton ball soaked in acetone in them because they're already acetone proof, they're silk off dishes. So they work really well just as holders on my desk, so stuff is not falling, polishes don't spill over. I really, really like these. I recommend, guys, if you guys can get your hands on them. They're really good. They fit the CJS stamping polishes really well. I usually just like keep them right in here. I wish I had a better place, but like, do I really want to move them down here? Because I don't, because it's my stamping stuff. So let's just keep stamping. We're stamping. It fits. It's fine.
Okay, guys. So this happened. I just moved everything out to see if it would fit in one of these drawers up here. Sorry, you guys are kind of crooked. I apologize. Up here. Now, that whole drawer would not fit in there. I'd still have to go for two. And I don't know if that really makes sense for me. For that, so I'm thinking I'm gonna move those more kawaii charms and all those type of things down in this drawer, and then maybe put like my big bling in there too. That would free up this big drawer. Like, these thick drawers are like gold to have, and I feel like this, all these little things in there, is just not utilizing that to its best. They can go in smaller drawers, or I was thinking I could put it in two smaller drawers up here. Do I really want to put it in two drawers? I don't know. I'll see. Now I'm thinking, would that work better? No, I don't think so. I think down here. We're gonna try down here. If I don't like it, then I move it around some other place. Let's move it all over. It's gonna set you guys back over here. Guys, I turned off that light. I hope that's okay. Oh, as I have ya. See, am I going to be able to go down? I have you on a stand. That's right here is where I put those little lights. So it kind of gives it a little bit of light down there. I think that's cute for when I'm like fully engulfed in everything. It gives it a little light because I put a light over here to see my polishes down there.
So guys, I just want to come in and say I'm so sorry. I must have turned the camera off when I thought I turned it on, and then when I turned it on, I actually thought I turned it off, because I have 20 minutes of just this and then me doing other stuff around. So I'm just gonna, this is basically how the drawer turned out. I think it turned out really, really well. I like it there. I did move the stuff from the bottom drawer up quickly because I just thought that all of those charms would be better at the very bottom. So I like it. I like the way everything turned out, and I think for now I'm going to get a lot more use out of it.
Okay guys, so we did that. I moved it there. I think I like it. I'm so debating if I should move my, yes Blue, we know you're here, if I should move my tips out of my desk and put them over here. It's not crazy for me to go from here and wheel my chair there to grab tips. Like, we use tips often, yes, you change them out often, especially now with my hand. I have a new practice hand. I don't know if I told you guys that yet. I'm just gonna move it out a little. Slow motion with me. All right. Or press-ons, whatever, right? Like, it's not that crazy to grab them if I wanted to switch that out. Would I rather have more freed up space? But do I really want miscellaneous in my desk? It's a hard one. I don't know, because it's a big project regardless. And I could change it. I gotta start looking here. I'm so sorry, guys. Yeah, I could change it back. It's not that crazy. I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think I'm gonna do it. I'm so scared. Like I said, these tall drawers are like gold, I find, in the studio. And I know if I have two tall drawers full of either tips or press-ons, I have one drawer press-ons and one drawer tips. I know one of those will not. That would be amazing if one of those would. I should maybe try and see if one of those, that would be awesome if I could put them right there. I just don't know. I don't think that would though. But I thought I would go over and we would recap what we've done today so far, and then we'll just call it, I guess. I've already literally have 2 hours full of organizing footage, just back and forth, and yeah. So I'm gonna have to cut that down a little bit. I think I'm gonna keep it a little bit longer though, because there's a lot of like, just like good organizing stuff. Like, it's a good organized video. Itchy eye. So I wanna show you, the studio is messy. Like, I didn't clean up yet, so I still have some work to do, but I don't think I'm gonna film that for you guys. If I do, I will, then I'll throw it in, but let's end it here so I can kind of figure out what I'm doing for the rest of it. And then I'll just tidy up the mess because she's messy. But if I feel there's anything else to put in, I'll...
Okay, so I wanted to show you up here first anyways. Like I said, she's messy. So this is new. I got a little rack in off Amazon. And I put all my CJS in it. I would love to be able to do like double racks. I can't. I don't have the space. I could go over, but this, like, I use that all the time. I have my pens and all that, like, I use that stuff. So to move that, and I really don't have anywhere else to put it, like, I don't want to put it here. So I think it's fine, like, I just have to be okay with it. So I did have to go back, like, they're doubled up. And like I said, I'm only missing the whole Halo collection but one, and then, like, I think four or five other colors, and then I have all of the CJSs. And then I have one rack up here, which... I think if they'll fit, I think I'm going to put my micro beads in it. If not, I don't know, because those polishes I showed you guys earlier, those tall purple ones, I'm going to end up putting up here at the back because they're pretty tall. They're going to need some space. So I grabbed a few of those. Now that I know I see the consistency, they look pretty D. So I like them. And these are the little, I got these little things off of Amazon too, just little hooks, just to kind of jazz it up a little. And then I took one of the heart hooks from there and I put it up there and it finally stayed. So I think I'm just gonna leave that for now, because they're the ones I wanted. They're off Shein. I might still get them eventually. I just honestly, there's nothing at Shein that really is entertaining me. The prices have gone up so much, and I'm just like, I can get that from Ali for cheaper and more too, like, you know what I mean? So I'm like, I just, guys, I know you probably want to see a Shein for me, but in all truth, there ain't nothing to tickle in my pants. And I just dropped the thing. Nothing tickling my fans over there. Okay, so let's go down here and look. As always, these threes are glitters. Okay, so we changed this drawer here. That's how this drawer looks now. I like that. Stay close, please. So that looks nice and neat. Here you get a better look at those little lights. And they do have a remote, and the remote actually will work for all three, so that's pretty cool. Again, I have to fix those cords. I keep forgetting that. Because that should not hang from here. Probably because it's like hooked on something. I don't know. But that's where the other polishes go now. And the model one, I took out all my model ones. So that's an empty one, which is good. So for now, I just left the label on it for now, just in case. But now I can grow just miscellaneous polishes because that's what's going in those bins. And okay, sorry, one more thing before we get back out of the drawer. I forgot. This I showed on Insta. I turned this one into all of Gellen. They just sent me a crazy kit, and I had a couple of kits already from them. So, and I love that they're colored. So I don't think I'm gonna even swatch them because I can see all the bottles, right? And right now I need label tape. I have some on the way, but I don't know, guys. Oh, and then my new Elena hand. That's the hand I got. That was the package that came like all busted up. Yeah, so it's a little chipped right here. That's it. I know. And then I had this hand that this goes onto the stand, but I had this extra little piece that works good that I put that on. And I got a thumb as well, so that kind of worked out well. Is that all on my desk that is new? I think so. Yeah, we have way more glitter to do something with. Another day. Okay, so that is that one. Okay, now this one here, I moved that up to the second drawer. I like that. So we have our cat eyes here. We have our acrylic paints. These are really good acrylic paints, but they're not the cheapest, I'm gonna lie. I do have some from the dollar store too. But yeah, I haven't really worked with them much. And then here we have our jelly gels, nothing, room to grow, and all of our inks and watercolors. And then just magnets. Again, we have some liners in there, more cat eye, stuff like that. And then down here changed, I put all of my like kawaii stuff. I have my Femos. I did end up putting this box down here as well, which is just my AB mix sizes. And I think that's fine down there. It fits good. It's not fitting over in the other drawer, and I don't want them to have a single drawer, so I think that's fine there. And I think I'm going to go on Ali and invest in three more of these same containers, and then I can go one here and then three, and that'll be six. And I have plenty, plenty of room for future gems or anything like that. I think that will work out really good. So I'm gonna get more of those little containers. I like them. Now over here, you guys have seen these. I can change it, but it's not, whoa. I don't like that. Okay. So that drawer's obviously been bumped around quite a bit for those gels to be all upside down. I don't like it. So I might have to figure that out in all truth. I'll have to put something beside them. You know what? I'm gonna have to get some foam tape. When in doubt, foam tape it up. So that was all nicely organized, but now for whatever reason. So these, the reason is that they all fit there. Which is, okay, they're missing a couple. I know why, they're actually in a different drawer. I'll show you that. So these all fit with two. Like I made these shelves to fit so I can get double the room. But again, so why did that fall? I don't know why that fell, guys. Mysteries. Again, this Venalisa one is exactly the same. Underneath is full of gels. So I really like the way they are, and because they fit all the little baby pots, they fit perfectly. And then that is all my Venalisas. I don't know why this one is like having difficulty shutting now. And I'm so curious if it's the weight of that drawer on it. Again, these are just other ones, miscellaneous underneath, different polishes and stuff. New products. New products is just like, we need to do a haul soon because this is full. The PR, I can't go in there. I actually have a couple PR, so you'll see that soon enough. And then this is new creations. And I wanted this drawer for sets that I want to do. Like this little set that I had, I already have it like drawn out. I want to do a Winnie the Pooh set. So all the stuff I need for is in it. And I feel like I could have four
and just have like my inspiration box. So it's like, okay, girl, let's get some art in, grab one of these and kind of have like ready to go. I really like that thought. So I want to try to implement that. Empty. Empty. Love me some empty drawers. Now over here, this one was a put away drawer. It still might stay as a put away drawer, but for right now it just has these like mixed crystals. I always like, I bag them and I give them to you guys, to be honest. And then sometimes you just go in there and find whatever inspo, but these are gonna go in a giveaway. So they're just there for now. Second, okay, so we just did that drawer. Like how that one looks. So that's all color gels. We just did that drawer. Like how that one's looking. I think poly gel can stay. Like, I left it for last, and you know what? I think it's good. We'll leave it where it is. It fills, these little containers fit perfect in there, and they were all labeled. Okay, Vanalisa's the only one not labeled, but. So we like that. This is rhinestones. This drawer fits fine. Again, they all fit to where they are. These I just kind of keep in their wheels because they're just like, I don't know, they're just like little things there. So I think they're fine. Like, it doesn't bother me. Again, that is, what do you call it? Like, Louis Vuittons and those little designer things. This I just had here because this is actually the giveaway. I was going to announce it this week, the week that I'm filming this. But I'm just going to do it one of the days, like early next week, because I'm going away and I won't have a chance to get it out to you guys. So it doesn't even make sense. So I'll wait till I can actually go and send it out. These drawers are staying the same. They have all of my, any charms in them. That's all they are, basically just charms. And charms again. These fit 10 of these trays, 5 up. So I can get one more here, which I have to try to find one more because I used one of these for, I had 10 exactly, but I used one for, what do you call them? The quiet charms, just the thing, and it worked really well. But I can't find them at Michael's. They're kind of, a lot of them are sold out. So these, I think the store is going to stay. I'm going to get a couple more if they have it, the dollar store, those little, these things, and try to put them in there. But this is polishes that I've gotten from companies, or products I've gotten from companies that I haven't implemented into my system. And I think I'm going to either keep them in their boxes because it's easy to grab, and then they're there, and they also could be for like a giveaway or something. So for now I'm just leaving them. These are some nice press-ons, so I like the box. I'm just keeping it in the box. It keeps it neat because there's 3 packs in there. My mom wants me to give her these ones, so I'm going to my mom's this weekend, so she wants me to put these on her or do her nails. That's what she said. She said, can you either do my nails like that or put them on me, because they're really, really short. She likes short nails. And I have to do sticky tabs because she can't wear nails. You're not gonna go right back in for me, are you? Oh, kinda. And then down here we have this miscellaneous drawer. See, I have this wood tray there for Blue not to get under, and he still tries to get under it. Yeah, so this just has literally miscellaneous stuff. So we have like glue, the Melody Susie press-ons, cute, really cute press-ons, some couple stands, things like that. They're not full, which is great, so I have room to like keep growing in them, and just different polishes and stuff. And that's it. That's what we've done so far today. Hold up. Okay, so I think that's it. I'm just sitting on the stool. It's actually kind of hard on the butt, I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna tidy up a little bit because I can't leave it like this, and I have to do some work tomorrow, so, and then get ready to go to my mom's. So I have so much to do, make sure I'm prepped and have everything to edit stuff and put stuff and get ready, and a lot of work, but it's okay. We're gonna figure it out, and then yeah, come home and do it all over again. That's basically what we do here, and that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I said it was just a lot of kind of rearranging and reorganizing and moving stuff. And that's what it is in the studio. You find stuff that's working for you, and then you buy some new stuff and you move it there, and it might not work anymore there. Then you move it back over there. It's kind of like this what you do. Do you know what I mean? But it's always nice and kind of fun to see what other people have and how they organize it. It gives you good ideas. So I'm hoping you guys got some good ideas from how I organized today. I truly like. I like organizing. I was thinking I was doing like a members thing. I know on YouTube you can do like members perks and stuff and that. And I was like, maybe I should do that and like take pictures, or you guys send me pictures and I can help you organize your area or something. I was thinking that, but I'm like, yeah, let's add more work. It'd be fun though. Like, I so would actually enjoy that. That's the crazy part, as like, I love to organize. It's my jam. So yeah, so I'm just gonna tidy up and I think that's it. I don't want to do too much. I have a lot of like book stuff to do, and I'm gonna leave my tips for now. Maybe I'll ask you guys in my Facebook group what you guys think, because I don't know, like, are they better in my desk? They're probably, I'm just gonna leave them in my desk. That's it. Executive decision. I think they're better there, because I don't think I want that miscellaneous drawer over here, and that's what that would create. That's the only way that would work. Or put my bling over here. I don't need my bling there either. So I answered my own question. But all right guys, I will see you in the next one, and have a great one. Bye.